Hi, today I want to talk to you about the five most important things to consider when you're buying professional LED lights. Now traditionally you would just say I need a 50 watt bulb or I need a 100 watt bulb. But when it comes to LED lights, there are so many things that are important to consider because you can really make a difference by making these small tweaks to the lights that you're buying. The first things that you want to consider is the lumen per watt. That means how much light do you get per watt used. This is the energy efficiency of the light bulb. And usually on normal lights, you would be used to something like 60 or 70 lumen per watt. Now, when it comes to LED, most of them are somewhere between 100 and 170 lumen per watt, which is quite a difference. Basically, you could be saving 70% more energy by choosing the right LED lights. Secondly, you want to talk about lumens output from the LED lights, not about the wattage coming in. The lumen output is exactly the light levels that are coming out of the LED fitting that you're buying. The great thing about that is that it will enable you to get a Dialux 3D rendering made of your premises, which will show exactly how much lux levels you're reaching on the floor level. Now, when it comes to lux levels, you want to sit down and find out exactly which lux levels you think is needed for your premises. Are you happy with the light levels that you have today, or would you like to improve it slightly? You need to go to the store. You can buy these really cheap. This is a lux meter, and you take a reading of your premises, and you see, is this good enough, or should we properly double the lux levels at floor level? Now in a spot like this, we're reaching 300 lux, which is really good. And actually, I could read a book in here. Now, when you've decided on the lux levels that you want, the third thing to consider is which beam angle is appropriate for your site. So, for example, the beam angle will show how much the spread of the light is going to the sides and how much is going to the ground. In a spot like we are right now here, we would use a much narrower beam angle to push as much light down to the floor as possible and reflect less lights onto the shelves and the side, and especially up in the top of the premises. So we've used a 60 degree beam angle in this spot. That's an important thing to do, to remember, because at floor level this is really going to make a difference. The other thing is that it's going to reduce glare a lot, which if it's outside, your neighbors are going to appreciate not having the glare from your premises. Now after that, you want to consider the Kelvin of the lights that you're buying. If you're running a cafe, then you want a cozy atmosphere, so you want a little more darker or yellower light. That would be 3000 Kelvin. In a spot like here, we're using 5000 Kelvin, which is called daylight color. And it really represents 5000 Kelvin. It's the same as you've got outside in sunshine. The last thing that you want to consider, and this is probably the most important thing, is which lifetime do you want from your LED fittings? This comes down to the driver, as it's the driver that is gonna burn out before the LED chips. If you use a high quality driver, we're using Meanwell from Taiwan, you will have a 5-year warranty, and these drivers are gonna last you from 5 to 10 years. If you use a less expensive driver, you'll probably just have 2 to 3 years lifetime of your LED fittings, and then you will have to install new ones. So definitely remember to choose a good driver brand with at least 5-year warranty. That was all. I hope you enjoyed this. And if you need any more information from us, please reach out to us either on phone or email or via our website. Thanks so much.